Wanda Faye here. Happy Saturday. It's almost 1:30 p.m. Pacific time on this June 22, 2024, 4:30 p.m. Eastern time. I'm going to go with the flow here and just read Ephesians 2, King James Version, public domain, just a little refresher word. And you hath he quickened, who were dead in sins and who were dead in trespasses and sins, wherein in time past ye walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had our conversation in times past in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace ye are saved, and hath raised us up together, and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. That in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Christ. For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Wherefore remember that ye, being in time past Gentiles in the flesh, who are called uncircumcision by that which is called the circumcision in the flesh made by hands, that at that time ye were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. But now in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were afar, were far off, are made nigh by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, who hath made both one, and hath broken down the middle wall of partition between us, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, even the law of commandments contained in ordinances, for to make in himself of twain one new man, so making peace, and that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby, and came and preached peace to you which were afar off, and to them that were nigh. For through him we both have access by one Spirit unto the Father. Now therefore ye are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto an holy temple in the Lord, in whom ye also are builded together for an habitation of God through the Spirit. Ephesians 2, 1 through 22. Lord, I just thank you for your word. I know that's a lot, God, but you know what? We can handle it. So I thank you for refreshing us, and we send your word out to our loved ones. Lift them up, God. Touch them, Lord. Maybe people that aren't like where we're at in the Lord, you know, like we think we, not just that we think that we are like doing it better than anybody else or anything like that, Lord. Just we're doing what we're doing, they're doing what they're doing. And so lift us all up, refresh us, heal us, deliver us, bless, provide every need, save, protect, in Jesus' name, amen. Thanks for watching. See you next time. God bless.